All right, let's talk here a little bit about hoovering. And if any of you guys are new here, I'm a self-aware narcissist that's trying to bring awareness, growth, change, and healing to people out there. Really, my message is trying to let other narcissists know that there is a problem out there, whether they want to believe it or not, and help other people, abuse survivors, that they can heal. And there is a way out of it. There is a way to have change. So let's talk about hoovering. So hoovering is the concept of where a narcissist has either discarded, or maybe you've left the narcissist and they want to get you back. So they want to hoover you back in. They want to be able to find a way to infiltrate your life, to be able to get to pass you on the street, to have something, some type of an interaction so that they can come back into your life. And typically that is so they can control you, so they can dominate whatever's going on. Sometimes it's just to mess with you, to see if it's possible, to see what they can accomplish. It can be very controlling, very manipulative. So oftentimes people ask me, I've been doing some one-on-ones now, interacting with different people on different continents and different places in life. And a lot of times people ask me, how do I know when it's the final discard, when he's actually done with me, when he's not going to come back, when I don't have to worry about it anymore? And there's a part of it you never really know. You never really know what's going to actually switch in their brains to actually not come back ever, to finally leave you alone. Sometimes it can be if a narc views it as being like a very big like injury or betrayal that they actually won't come back. But more often than not, they're going to come back. More often than not, they're going to try to hoover you. They're going to try to come back into your life. They're going to try to be somewhere in your life, interacting with your friends, your job, your family, your church, whatever it might be. They might be trying to do that to be able to get back into your life in some form or the other. So the thing you have to be careful of is watching out for that. So that's why normally we talk about leaving a narcissist, going no contact, ghosting, blocking on every type of social media you can think of, on every type of payment system, music out there, whatever it might be, like blocking them so they can't get back to you. So here's the thing that I've been trying to tell a lot of people and have them understand, because this is part that people seem to struggle with. They keep asking, when will I know that it's the final discard? When will I know that he won't try to hoover me ever again? How do I know when it's done? The only way that the narc is going to stop hoovering you, and you have to worry about that like 100%, is when you stop it. When you don't let there be any access. Because sometimes people are asking like, wait, he didn't come back. You know, maybe I was the problem. He didn't come back. Maybe he's having a better life now. No, that's not the thing. The thing is, you have to lock the door. You have to throw away the key. You have to barricade those walls so that the narc cannot get back through. Because if there's any crack in those doors, if there's any opening for them to be able to weasel their way back into your life, they will do it. How do you know when a narc is going to be done hoovering you? When you take away the access. You can't expect them to walk away. You can't expect them to be the bigger person. You can't expect them to have the emotional maturity or stability to actually step away and walk away from you. If it comes down to it that you know you have to leave, you know that relationship has to end, walk away, block, ghost, go no contact, and keep it that way. Then you don't have to worry about, are they actually gonna come back? Don't give them access. Don't give them a way to come back. Now, I know this message can sound really harsh and can sound really hard, especially for those of you out there who have kids, because that can be a really difficult situation of co-parenting, or maybe both parents have access to the kids, things like that. And you don't have the access of completely ghosting. You do have the access of channeling communication through a third party, channeling communication through email, channeling communication through another person or a family member or something like that to help limit that no contact, to be able to keep it separated, keep that distance. You want to have it so you're not interacting with the narcissist. You want to have it so you're not worried about them emotionally triggering you or mentally abusing you. So the more you can keep that barrier there, the more effective it's going to be. And then if you have kids and that's the route you have to go with having a third party or going through email or some other form of communication that's a little bit more safe, you also have to just work with your kids to help grow them and help them to be emotionally mature adults, because the narc isn't going to do that job for you. So the best you can, go no contact. Try to limit contact if you have to contact because of kids or anything like that. Set up a third party, go through email, like whatever it might be, but please help take care of yourself. The narc isn't going to leave on their own. They're not going to be mature enough to stay away. They're not going to respect you enough to stay away. They didn't respect you enough when they were in your lives. They're not going to respect you enough when they're out of your lives. So if you're worried about when is the final Hoover, or when are they not going to try to come back, is when you stop them from coming back because you've removed all access, all options for them to be able to contact you, reach out to you, or anything like that. So stay strong, go ghost, go no contact, work on yourself, and develop yourself to be the best that you can possibly be, and work on getting through that trauma that has been put onto you by someone else. Know that you can be awesome and grow no matter what you've been through.